Going on, everyone. Rabid here, and we're taking a look at Radiant. So about a month ago, maybe even longer, I can't even remember, but I did show you guys how to mine Radiant, and now we're revisiting it a bit because it seems to be getting a little more popular. Also, we're looking at overclock settings. So since then, BZMiner has added support for Radiant, and in this, we're going to look at HiveOS with my RTX 3080 on the test bench, and we're also going to go to the workstation, and for you Windows users, have a quick peek at the RTX 3090, because that's what I got in my workstation here. But regardless, we're going to look at some hash rates, profitabilities, and how to overclock this. So the other day, at the time of watching this, currently today of recording, OCTOMINER did add it under the coin section. So it's not publicly displayed, but it is now within the coin section itself. And at 122 watts and 11 cent power and 1.04 gigahash or 1040 megahash, we're getting about 11 cents after power, which is about 3 or 4 times more profitable than Caspa. So if you really love Caspa, maybe you could mine this and then swap it in for Caspa or whatever other coin you want. But so far, this is looking like a fairly profitable coin. And it was even, you know, a month ago when we did make you that how to mine video. Now, I also did the numbers within my spreadsheet here, and the same thing works out. Now, this is showing me that we should actually be making about 15 cents based on the current hash rate and price of the coins, 47 cents before power, and then 32 cents at about 122, 123 watts here after power is that profitability of about 15 cents. So take it any way you want, either OCTOMINER saying 11 cents or my sheet is telling us a bit more. It is profitable. So let's take a look at some quick overclocking settings. So this is one of the most efficient settings I have found yet. Remember, you could drop the core from what I'm about to show you and get more efficient. This is just like a maybe a baseline for you guys, and always do your own tweaking. Silicon lottery and everything does apply, but I'm going to go into my flight sheet here and just show you what's going on. Now, if you remember the Caspa video from the other day, I'm using pretty much the exact same settings and we're using pretty close to the same power. So obviously that was LOL miner here. We got a lock core clock of 1470 and a mem lock of 810. If I come into my actual Radiant flight sheet now, I'm gonna hit the edit button and just show you what I got going on. So here, I'm still locking the core at the same 1470 and the memory is overclocked or locked, I guess in this case, at 810. And instead of adjusting the core voltage within HiveOS or in Windows, it would be Afterburner, we're actually setting that offset in the miner config itself. So here we have that same 400 that we did do with Caspa. And if we go into overview, you can see I don't have anything here, no power limit, no nothing set. Now it is recommended to set a power limit, but again, that should be done within the mining software itself just to make things kind of jive a little better. But we can see here that at the wall, I'm using about 142 watts or so. Full system, my system uses 20 to 22 watts. So we're just gonna drop 20 off that. And we're around that 120 watt version. And in the software, it's saying 117. So it's about 3 watts off. So we're very close to what we actually are at the wall, at least in this case. And that's what we're gonna have to base when I go into Windows, is what the software is telling us, because at the watt meter with the 7950X and everything, I'm not gonna get an accurate number, but I will show you how to still set it up. And for the current settings I have in terms of efficiency, we can see 1.042 gigahash, again, about 120 watts. That is 1,042 megahash. So we're gonna do this in the megahash to watt ratio. And if we divide that together, that is 8.68 megahash to watt of a ratio. So I'm gonna adjust the settings here to what some people are using and other ones. And it is slightly less efficient, but we're just gonna have a quick look. So we're gonna keep the same settings here and we're just gonna adjust our clock to, I believe, 1675 is what some people like to use. So I'm gonna apply that. We're gonna update it and just wait for everything to do its thing. We'll come back and show you the numbers. Okay, so I lied. We're actually a little bit more efficient now, but you can see we're at 1.19 gigahash, so 1,190 megahash. At the wall, we're using a total of around 156 watts. So that's 136 watts with the GPU. That works out to be 8.75 megahash per watt. So we are actually a little more efficient. So we could do a lot more tweaking here. I'm gonna leave that to you guys to play with, but you can see what we're going here. So find some nice overclock settings that work best for you, and then just roll with it and mine yourself some Radiant. I'm going to plug in these new numbers and see, you know, what the profitability looks like on what to mine. All right, so coming back to what to mine, we're actually making 14 cents now after power. So that's pretty good, guys. GPU mining to the moon. Let's roll. Just kidding, guys. We're still not looking very good, but there is a little bit of profit to at least be had. So whether you decide to mine, obviously it depends on your power price and what you want to do, and if you believe in a coin or just swap into another coin, or if you're just hodling, paying out of pocket. Everyone's doing something different, but we are at least making on a single RTX 3080 14 cents after power at 11 cent power. All right, Windows users, you are not forgotten. So we're going to take a look at this in Windows. Again, this is an RTX 3090 now. I don't know 100% of how much power is going to be drawn because they got my 7950X, fans, AIOs, everything on there. So we won't be looking at power. We're going to be basing it on software. And remember, it's going to be using a bit more power than what software tells us. So we're just going to right click on BZMiner once you extract it, just like everything you want it to run as an administrator, before you, when you set your settings and run that bat file. So you're gonna go to compatibility here, run this program as administrator, simply click that button, hit apply, and every time you run the bat file, it will do that. So there is a bat file already for Radiant within the latest BZMiner. Here you can find it right here. You're gonna right click that, edit it to open it up, and adjust the parameters as needed. So it default, it's pointing to Wooly Pooly and everything. I did change that and move that over to Rplat for testing purposes. Here it will be a bunch of zeros on default, so you're going to want to put your address in this section here right after the W part, and then just a period and whatever your worker name is, in this case WS because it's my workstation, and then I'm not sure what that does, but I just ignored it. And then you're going to need your overclocking parameters, or locking your core mem and that offset. So if you actually go to BZMiner itself, through the readme here, it'll tell you all the parameters, and here it can say OC memory clock offset, OC clock offset, and you know, OC memory clock offset 2. So the 2s here means your second algorithm. If you're dual mining, then you'd be adding that in under that second algorithm or pool that you'd be mining to, but we're just going to be using these. So you can see it all right here. I will have these in the description below, so you can just simply copy them and adjust the clocks and memory and everything to your own liking to try your own testing. In this case, we're going to try 1675. We're going to go with the 810 and the OC core clock offset. We're going to go with the 400 again. So the exact same settings I was using HiveOS, but this time it is an RTX 3090. Once you get that saved, simply obviously hit the save, or in order to save it, hit the save button. And then we're going to come in, open it up, double click. It will ask for admin privileges right there. Yes, we want it. And then we simply wait for it to go. So it's going to ask to connect, say yes, just like every other miner already did that. So it's not asking again. We can see the core offset was set to 400. We do have the lock core of 1675, and the locked mem is at 810. So now we just got to wait for this thing to start hashing and giving us some numbers. And it's already doing that. So yeah, so we're already at 217 watts. So obviously we do probably need to do some more tweaking. We're probably utilizing what, like 225, 220 or something like that, the wall potentially, but I don't know. I don't have an accurate number here. And we're doing about, where are we at here? 1.28 gigahash. So not too hot, but I do have a bunch of windows open right now. So that is reducing my hash rate. So I would have to close everything out and only have the miner running, because obviously our monitor is running at 4K. It's at 144 hertz, and all these things is pulling a little bit away from the GPU, which does reduce your hash power, which is why it's recommended to use the HDMI onboard graphics within your motherboard itself, integrated graphics, so on. But this is for testing purposes to show you how to actually do this. So hopefully this does help you out. So we're going to try this again. I'm actually going to drop the core clock lock down to about 1530. Just make sure I save this again, close that out, and now double click. And we're going to see what kind of numbers we may be getting now. So we're going to close this out as well. We don't want as many things open. I got tons of stuff open, so we're not going to see full hash. But let's just see what this looks like. So it's already saying 120 watts. Did it actually drop it that much? I can't remember what it said initially on the other one. but we'll see what happens. So, okay, now we're at 205. So it wasn't saying that. We did lose a little bit anyway. We lost some power. Our hash rate is down a bit, but we'll see. We're actually lower than what the 3080 was giving us, but you know, let this run for a couple minutes and we'll come back. All right, guys. So that does pretty much wrap up this video. I did get it to about 1.26. I closed everything out and let this thing run in the background for just a few minutes, nothing major. But this is just a quick tutorial on how to actually lock your cores and everything within BZMiner and set this. And it is pretty much the same settings that you would use for Caspa. Now, I want to close this out with looking at what's all in the latest release. It looks like it fixed Radiant and RX 580 cards, so Polaris cards. Something about Radiant dual mining issue is fixed, so you can dual mine something else as well. And duplicate share issues on Radiant as well. So a few things regarding Radiant was within this latest update, and it looks like 15 days ago. So if you have some better overclock settings or found some nice efficient numbers, let me know as well as everyone else in the comment section below. Hopefully this helped you out in overclocking for Radiant. And are you guys even mining Radiant in the first place? Thank you for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.